guests from the public sector, Congressman, Mayor, Vice Mayor, Governor. Thank you all for being here, to our friends from the industry, from HSMA, our sponsors. Really appreciate all of you being here. Thank you for being here in the first inaugural, no? It's in our first Choose Philippines Awards. Choose Philippines, the website was created 5 years ago. And before, no, during that time, it was just a normal website where we post articles and pictures. And fast forward 5 years, we saw that we reinvented the entire website, and we believe in one mission and one vision for the website. We said that we believe that the job of marketing the Philippines is not confined to the only by the Department of Tourism and by the LGUs. It is the job of every Filipino. And because of that, we said we have to make sure that the website that we created should be something that is very friendly, but at the same time, everyone can help use that website to market it to everyone around the world. For one thing, I always tell people I'm very guilty. The first 30 years of my life, I've been to more cities around the world than the cities here in our country. But as I was exposed, no, giving talks and you know, going to the different localities in our country, that is when I realized one thing. Lagi kong sinasabi yan, ang ganda pala ng Pilipinas. And because of that, unti-unti, no, of course, with Congressman Zelteta, mayon has always been a staple. People do not associate me na umiikot sa Pilipinas. Parang last month I was in Baler, and I told my people, nangitim ako dahil nag-surfing. No one believed. Sabi ko, nakaka-insulto na kayo. Kasi walang naniwala sa akin. No? And, you know, right now, I said, more than ever, we have to make sure that given the growth and rise of travel, tourism, of economies around the world, we have to, it's really our challenge, how do we market the Philippines? I remember I was galing ang Shaman last time, last Christmas, no? So I went with my dad there. We met with the one of the tourism, parang local government official niya. Sabi nga niya, parang, he was so proud of the city, and he said, alam mo, the number of tourists coming inside Shaman is bigger than the tourists going into the entire Philippines. And sabi, that's the challenge I throw to you. And when I was talking to the Department of Tourism, kay Secretary Teo, and I was telling her, we have to all help each other market the Philippines. Hindi pwede kanya-kanya, no? For example, badly put, nag-lecture na. But may mga ibang LGUs, may mga tourism apps na ginagawa, tourism website. Sabi ko, okay lang yun, maganda sana. But sana we get an integrated marketing or a tourism app that's for the entire Philippines. Right? So any tourist who comes in can actually just use that app, you know, and you point into around to everywhere, no? Parang pwede kang gumana parang Pokemon challenge, or in the Japan kasi I butterfly ang gamit nila. So there are so many things that we could do if we look at it from a overall perspective. You know, I really hope that we really ang laki ng dependency ng success ng isang bansa sa tourism. Eh. So we really hope that all of you help us in this endeavor. Under our domain, all our digital products, most of them kino-commercialize namin. But to be very fair to our management, even our company, pagdating sa Choose Philippines, hindi nila binibilang yan na kailangan may advertising ba, may ganun, hindi. It's really an advocacy, kailangan i-promote ang Pilipinas. No? So with that, so we said, how else can we push this website, this advocacy forward? Then we said, maybe maggawa tayo ng standards of excellence. And that is why Choose the Philippines Awards was conceptualized. Gawa tayo ng standards of excellence, and let's reward those who are excellent and the best of the best. To those who are here, most of you here, you are finalists. And I just want to reiterate, if it hasn't been to you, that being a finalist is no, hindi siya biro. Kasi out of more than 30 in your respective category, sinala na yan to the top 5. So it's medyo may dinaanan na yan. No? And then the grand jury actually voted for each of you. And the jury, it's a long list. It's not even just 5 of them or 10 of them. It's a very big, massive number of jury who really voted for you. So you're all actually winners already. No? I'm short of saying the least. So before I end, let me just show you how the website would look, no? But we've actually redesigned the entire website, and we wanted to make it more very extremely friendly to our visitors. But at the same time, hopefully all of the LGUs, all of the different groups can actually put in content, so we can actually promote you further, no? Ang advantage naman kami as a marketing platform, as media, we can actually promote your individual localities, no? When we create a website, usually we create what we call a manifesto, what we believe in, what our website should uphold, no? So first is that our travels are made more meaningful because we choose wonder. It is in every historical site we visit, every natural bounty we discover, and every haven we relax in. We choose freedom. It is in every peak we reach, every wave we surf, and every road we walk on. We choose passion. It is in every region we explore, every local treat we try, and every inspiring Pinoy we meet. So discover, experience, share, choose Philippines. So you will see how we redesigned it. Hindi na siya yung lumang website. It's a very interactive platform already where people can really engage. Our set of user-friendly features make sharing and discovering meaningful travel stories a more enjoyable experience. So predictive search function, among many others. I won't go through a lecture now, but next slide. So basically, that's how it will look already, no? Predictive search function. So if you even type in certain keywords of your locality or your site that you have, lalabas na siya automatically, no? Next slide. And then we also have an Instagram aggregator page. Like I've said, when we started Choose Philippines way before, no, I wasn't the one who started, it was Charlie Villa and her team. Ang laki ng budget sa travel, no? Kailangan pumunta dito, we have to cover, we have to write an article. And that's when we realized, teka lang, we're doing it all wrong. Why? People are traveling already. Let's get people who travel, just post it for us and contribute articles for us so that the site could become bigger and become richer in terms of articles and in terms of the experiences of people. So an Instagram aggregator allows anyone now who has an Instagram, can just, ilalagay na lang nila dito, no? Ano yung travel experience nila. So all of you who goes to your locality, to go to your, you know, who went to your site, can actually just post how much they enjoyed, you know, their experience with each of you. There's a location page, so there's an individual page for each destination. So yun ang kailangan naming tulong from each of the LGUs, no? We're trying to create a database of each of your best heritage site, cultural site, natural wonder. We will try to put everything there. So para siyang maging talaga Wikipedia. If everyone wants to look for the Philippines and wants to travel to us, we'll put everything there and it becomes an encyclopedia of destinations. There's also a traveler's market. So if you have special festivals, if you have bazaars, special occasions, we put it there and people can, you know, all the more, give more people reason to come to our place. And then, of course, what we will commit to in each of the LGUs, maybe, if you have special festivals, occasions, ila live stream namin. So what we can do now is that when we can actually run to you and we will pag-shoot namin yung festival ninyo, we will put it on our website so we market it more to everyone. We have a user dashboard. So what will happen is that every user now who goes to our site when they register can actually identify themselves. Then at the same time, meron silang parang wish list saan nila gustong puntahan, at done that, parang bucket list chine-check nila, no? So yun ang gusto ko sana, may bucket list tayo ng all the best places in the Philippines. Then everyone around the world can use that as a bucket list, check nila, no? At the same time, yung wish list, if for example, from a marketing perspective kasi, kung alam natin na gusto niyang puntahan, no, they want to go to a specific place, we can actually even create marketing programs to send to that particular individual. So mas maintay siya pumunta. Okay? And then of course, the user profile. And hopefully we can work with everyone. So as they build up their user profile, we begin to know the profile of our tourists, of guests who are coming to our country, and we can actually provide better marketing messaging for them. Okay, so with that, I hope that you, I won't talk much because pag binigyan niyo ako ng mic, mahaba ako magsalita. I hope you enjoyed tonight, no? Like I said, this is, bear with us. We have very sincere intentions, yun lang. We want to market the Philippines. We hope you work with us. this is our first inaugural. No, we will be having asking most of our industry partners with the different LGUs. Hopefully, you become part of our jury also later on, advisory council, as we make this bigger. Kasi we want talaga sana, in the end, as the world becomes more global, ang kalaban natin global na. No? So we have to all do our share in marketing the Philippines. So let me end with this one last, you know, very quick 30-second video about Choose Philippines, and thank you and enjoy the night.
Change is happening online. New things to explore on Choose Philippines. Just visit choosephilippines.com. More interesting stories, photos, and videos of your target destinations. Hear personal experiences of travelers. Get to share your travel adventures, updates on travel deals and promos, plus live streaming of Philippine festivals. More travel adventures to discover Pilipinas wanderers. Choose Philippines.
Piliin mo ang Pilipinas.